Dear friends, ladies and gentlemen, we have a strange attitude in the Commission whenever we are referring to our own country that we are saying the country I know best, so welcome to the building I know best. It's a real pleasure for me to be with you this evening, and I'm proud to support the development of the European Red Lists of Species. Excellent work. Too often, we take nature for granted, and too often we forget how valuable it is. Nature contributes to our well-being and our survival by giving us food, fresh water, clean air, by giving us shelter and medicines, by mitigating natural disasters, pests, and diseases. Nature, its biodiversity, its ecosystems, its species, its habitats make life possible and are the main drivers of our economy. Thanks to the work of the IUCN, we now have a database that provides sound scientific data that will allow us to assess the status and trends of species and habitats in the European Union. This data, together with the information provided by the member states, will allow us over time to measure progress and to assess if our policies on nature and biodiversities are on the right track. This is very important because the strain we keep on putting on our ecosystems has led to a serious loss of biodiversity. As we have heard, the first results of the Red List assessments confirm previous assessment that we are still losing biodiversity in the European Union. We have heard, but it's worth repeating, that the Red List figures reveal that in Europe at least 44% of all freshwater mollusks, 37% of all freshwater fish, and 23% of all amphibian species which have been assessed are threatened with extinction. This is absolutely extremely worrying. The well-being of people in Europe and all over the world depends on goods and services the nature provides. The degradation of biodiversity has significant health, social, environmental, economic consequences. If we do not address the reasons behind this decline and act urgently to stop it, we could pay a very and heavy price. But there are some glimmers of hope. The role of biodiversity in delivering essential services is receiving more and more political attention in the European Union, and several European Union member states are following up on the report of the Economics of Ecosystems and Biodiversity, so-called TIP, report at national level. At EU level, the EU Biodiversity Strategy adopted by the Commission last May, I hope I can say it's very ambitious and has put us, hopefully, on the right track. Strategies, policies, targets in this strategy are very important, but as an economist, I know perfectly well that to be successful, we need to base our decisions and actions on a solid data. With the European Red List of Species, we now have European Union-wide Red List data available for a wide range of species groups, including mammals, amphibians, reptiles, freshwater fish, dragonflies and butterflies, as well as for selected groups of beetles, mollusks and vascular plants. This work will also provide useful input to the Life Plus program as part of the species selection criteria for Life Plus biodiversity projects. And it will help improve the general understanding among policymakers, the interested parties, and the general public for the need of European conservation action on biodiversity and ecosystem services. So what exactly needs to be done? These Red List results confirm that we need to step up our efforts in implementing the Birds and Habitats Directives. Since most of the Red Listed species are either listed already in the annexes of these directives or benefit from the conservation of natural habitats in the Natura 2000 network. We also need to look beyond Natura 2000 at the biodiversity on our doorstep and in the wider countryside. The work we are undertaking on green infrastructure with a planned strategy in 2012 and on the development of a no net loss initiative by 2015 will be crucial in this respect. The integration of biodiversity and Natura 2000 into the common agriculture policy, cohesion policy and maritime and fisheries policies will of course also be crucial to our success. The Commission's proposals for these policies are now on the table. They include a number of essential provisions that can help achieve our biodiversity target, but the ball is now in the Member States and in the European Parliament's court. To succeed, we also need to step up our efforts at the global level. The 10th Conference of Parties to the Convention on Biological Diversity last October was an important success for global biodiversity policy. The meeting COP11 that will take place in India next year will focus primarily on how to finance the commitments made in Nagoya. Here again, we will need to keep the pressure to make sure that all parties deliver their fair share. In all these European and global developments, direct lists play an important role in telling us where we stand and if we are going in the right direction or not. However, the work on European red lists is still not complete. This year, the Commission will support the production of red lists for four further important groups: birds, marine fish, pollinating insects, and medicinal plants. The decision already taken for marine fish, if I'm well informed, it's in the process. Together with the crop, wild, relative plant species assessed already, pollinators and medicinal plants will add another interesting dimension to this work. Linking the status of species to the state of key ecosystem services. This will be another important step, and I thank once again IUCN for the excellent work. Ladies and gentlemen, over the past centuries, human genius and creativity have led to great achievements, providing us with unprecedented comfort and also well-being. But this is often at the detriment of our most precious resource, nature. And the data provided by the red lists speak for nature. Allow me to conclude by quoting from the essay of Travels of the Scottish writer Robert Louis Stevenson. It is not so much for its beauty that the forest makes a claim upon men's hearts, as for the subtile something, that quality of the air, that emanation from the old trees, that so wonderfully changes and renews the very spirit. That was written more than a century ago, in 1905. It is high time to be finally understood by majority of us, especially by us politicians. It is thus time for nature. Yes, it is, as you said, high time to act, and act now. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you, Commissioner Potocnik. You have a challenge on your hand with the new biodiversity strategy. We're ready to help. The red list certainly can give you some of the information.